Hello children, right? I'm back again with another lesson in English today, right? Now open your term 3 textbook on to page number 26. Yes, so today we are going to look into lesson number 3, that is Sabina's composition. Okay, Sabina's composition. So let's see what the lesson is all about on a page number 26, children. Do you do your homework on your own or does someone help you? One day, Sabina does her homework without even knowing it. How does that happen? Read to find out. So there is a girl by name Sabina. Okay, now do you all do your own homework? Yes, we do. And sometimes we take our parents' help also. Yes, so this little girl, she has done her homework without anybody's help. Okay, so how did she do and what happened? Let's look into this. Sabina came home from school one day with her eyes red and teary. So the Sabina girl, she came back from school and she was crying. Her eyes were very red and teary. Teary means about to cry. What happened? Her mother asked as she hugged Sabina. So mother, when she reached home, she saw Sabina like the mother saw Sabina like that, and she hugged Sabina and she asked, "What happened, my dear?" "I don't know what to do," Sabina cried. "Our teacher said that we must all bring in a composition tomorrow morning. I can't write compositions. In school, I tried to write on 3 different topics, but see, I can't do it." Okay, so what Sabina is telling, "See mama, I don't know how to write. My teacher told me to write a composition. Composition means the teacher is going to give you one topic and you have to write on that particular topic." Okay, now if your teacher tells you to write a composition on a book, okay, book will be the topic and you are going to write about a book. Okay, what type of books we have, how are we going to use the books, what are the different subjects we have, okay, and how do you read the book and how do you write in a book. So all that we express our ideas. So that expressing our idea in a written form, in the form of a big essay, is called as a composition. Okay, so teacher, Sabina's teacher, gave a composition for the children to write, and this little girl, she tried on different topics but she was unable to write, and she teacher wanted the composition next day morning only. Very horrible, right? Her mother took Sabina's notebook. Sabina had tried to write on the topic time, knowledge and freedom. So Sabina, she opened, the mother took her notebook and she searched what all did she write. Okay, so she took the book and she saw the topics were time, knowledge and freedom. This is what she had written. Time is short, we should all improve our time. Knowledge is a very useful thing. Freedom must be used wisely, that's all. Okay, now I can't think of another word to say about any of these topics, exclaimed Sabina. I shall have to go to school without a composition. Okay, so she started to try to write on these 3 topics. Time she told, time is short and we should all improve our time, means we should improve how to manage our time. On knowledge is a very useful thing, but she did not write how it is useful and why it is useful, and if we misuse it, what will happen? But you know, she did not write. And freedom must be used wisely. So she just wrote one sentence, but she did not give a complete description of her ideas. So she told mother, "Now these are the topics which I wrote, and tomorrow whenever I am going to school, I should go to school without a composition." Sabina, her mother asked, "Did the teacher ask you to write on these topics?" So mother is asking, "Did the teacher give you these topics?" "No, mummy, she just suggested them. We can choose any topic we want, but it's so difficult to find a proper topic." So mother got a doubt. Okay, did these topics your teacher give you? Sabina said, "No, mama, these were only generally my teacher spoke. Okay, if you want, you can choose these. But she told to write on our own, and I'm not anything. You have done enough worrying, said mummy. So you are worrying a lot. Come on, stop the worry. You did not begin correctly. You have been trying to write on subjects that you don't know much about. So mother is suggesting her, she's explaining her what are all the mistakes Sabina has done. So mother is telling, see, you did not write correctly, my dear daughter. The subject what you chose is not proper. But I just can't find a subject. Sabina's mother shook her head. Go and play in the garden. I will call you in half an hour. So mother is telling, Sabina is telling, I can't find any topic. I can't find any subject. So mother is telling, come on. Now you go and play in the garden. After half an hour, I'll call you. But my composition, began Sabina. Don't think about your composition. Have fun, said her mother. So mother said, don't worry about the composition. Just enjoy. Go have fun and play in the garden for half an hour. After half an hour, when her mother called her, Sabina looked fresh and happy. Okay? So she was so tensed because she was not knowing how to write a composition. So many thoughts were ringing in her mind, but nothing she could put it down. So she was worried. Now mother suggested her, come on, leave away all your thoughts. Don't worry. Just go and relax. Have fun and come. So after half an hour, when Sabina came back, she looked fresh and happy because she was not having that worry in her mind. Now said her mother, I want you to sit by the window with a sheet of paper and pencil and write something about what you can see. So now mother is asking, come on, now sit near the window, take a paper and a pencil, okay? Now just write what you can see. What is the description you have to write? Never mind, but my composition, sir, asked Sabina, when will I begin that? So now Sabina is worried only about the composition. So mother, Sabina is asking, Mama, I have to write my composition. No. Then, never mind your composition. We will talk about that later. So mother is telling, don't worry. First you write what all you are able to see. Sabina knew that her mother always had a good reason for everything she did. So she took the paper and pencil and sat down by the window. So Sabina was very confident. Okay, whatever my mother tells, it's for my good. And she took a pen and a pencil and a paper. She sat near the window. She was ready to write. Sabina looked out and saw the western sky and some bright sunset clouds. What a lovely sunset, she exclaimed. Don't tell me, said her mother. Just write. So now she was admiring the nature. So she said, what a beautiful sunset, Mama. So mother said, come on, don't tell me anything. You write it down. So Sabina began to write about the sunset. She described the orange and pink clouds. She wrote about the distant hills, the trees, the rivers, the garden and the birds flying past the window. And Sabina continued writing. She forgot all about the terrible composition. So now Sabina started to write about the sunset. Okay, so she described the color of the clouds, how it is. Then she wrote about the hills, the trees, the garden, the birds and all she was thinking and she was writing. Then soon her mother came up to her and asked, are you done? Have you finished it? Let's read your composition. So now mother is coming. Okay, did you write, my dear? Is it over? Okay, now let's see, what did you write in your composition? Composition? Exclaimed Sabina. You told me not to think about my composition. I just had a nice time writing about what I could see from the window. I'll read out and what I wrote. So Sabina began reading. So Sabina said, Mama, you did not tell me about composition. No, you told me to write what all I can see. So I wrote what all I could see. Okay, now let me tell you what I wrote. I'm sitting on a low seat near the window and I can smell the sweet flowers in the garden. The sky is all bright and bright with sunset. I can see purple, pink and golden. I do not think that anyone on earth has a paint box with such lovely colors in it. So she's describing her composition. She's telling about the sunset. See, I'm sitting near the window. I can see smell the beautiful flowers of the garden. I can see the bright sunset. Okay, the purple, pink and golden color, and nobody can paint like that also. There is one cloud above the rest, which looks like a ship sailing in the blue sea. I would like to sail on a cloud if I would not make me dizzy. The green hills look as if they are wearing golden crowns. I can see a river far away. It seems quite still, although I know it is running as fast as it can to get to the ocean. So now she is describing about the cloud, the blue cloud, okay, and one small blue cloud which is like a ship which is sailing in the blue sea. Then she could also see the green hills which are there. They are wearing like a golden crown, and she can also see a river which is running very fast to meet the ocean. The birds are flying past the window to go home and take care of their little ones. I'm glad that birds are not afraid to live in our garden. Our garden is full of flowers like lilies and roses. Mummy calls this the month of roses. So she's describing about the birds. Birds are flying, they are going back home. Okay, it is time for them to rest. And I am very much happy that my birds are not afraid to come and visit my garden. We have got different flowers like lilies and roses in our garden. And mummy would call this month as month of roses. The sight from our window is very beautiful indeed. When she finished, Sabina's mother began clapping. This is a lovely composition. Okay, so mother said, after hearing all this, mother was very happy. She clapped to her daughter saying that it's a wonderful composition. A composition? Exclaimed Sabina. Is that a composition? So now she did not know that it was a composition, but she expressed all her ideas over there, what all she could see. Yes, Sabina, and a very good one, replied her mother. But it does not even have a subject, said Sabina. So her mother said, yes, my dear, it is a composition. Then Sabina said, Mama, how can you tell this is a composition? There is no subject only, no. We can find one for it, continued her mother. Haven't you written about the beauty of nature? So mother said, okay, we'll try to find out. Yes. Now, did you not write about the beauty of nature? Yes, it's all about nature only. The sun, the clouds, the mountains, the hills, the birds, the river, everything is present in the nature. Oh yes, exclaimed Sabina. You see, her mother explained, it is easy to write if you have something interesting to write about. So, always remember children, if you want to write something, you should have interest. Okay, if you have that interest, you can write n number of things. The next morning, as Sabina left to school, she gave her mother a kiss and said, isn't it strange that I wrote such a long composition without knowing it? Okay, so she was so happy. She kissed her mother next morning when she was going to school and she said, see, Mama, it is so strange, no? Without knowingly, I wrote a composition. I'm very happy for that. Right? Yes. So from this lesson, what do we learn, children? Very small story, but very meaningful. Okay, I'll tell you. The main theme of this story goes like, we should never be afraid of anything. Okay? You need to try. Give a try. Then only you will be successful. Okay? If you are tensed, you cannot write anything. You cannot think anything. But if you are relaxed and having a very cool mind, your thoughts will come and then you can write very well. At the same time, we have to have interest in every work, whatever we are doing. Okay, children? See, any work I do, suppose I'm teaching now. If I don't have an interest in teaching, will my classes be interesting? No. You all will feel bored. Arey babre, this Kamala ma'am came up. Why did she come and what is she teaching? I will never understand. Yes? Yes. So, if that interesting part is not there, you will feel bored. Right? Yes? If the movie is interesting, then you feel, oh yes, I should see what is going to happen next. Yes? And if your mother has cooked very well and you have the interest to eat, you start eating more. Yes? And when you have an interest, you talk to your parents. You sit and you go on explaining to them, you talk to them. Right? So, everything depends on our interest. So if you have interest, you can do anything, right? You should also have interest in studying. Understood, children? Because we should never neglect our studies. Put lot and lot of interest in studies and grow up very brightly. Understood, children? Yes. So a very small and lovely story. Yes, I enjoyed telling it to you all. Hope you must have also enjoyed it. Right? Okay, children. See you all in the next video. Until then, take care. Bye-bye.